What's going on, guys? Boy TG, and today we are going to be breaking down some of Sidney Crosby's best plays. Last time we did Connor McDavid's speed, we did Austin Matthews' shot, we did some NHL goals breakdown. So now we're going to be breaking down some of Sidney Crosby's best plays. Now, Sidney Crosby, he's a player I grew up watching. He's actually one of my favorite players. That's why you see this poster of him on my wall, because he's one of my favorite players. And I grew up watching him. Three-time Stanley Cup champion with the Pittsburgh Penguins. He won it in 2009, 2016, and 2017. Two of those years, he won the Conn Smythe for playoff MVP. So, without further ado, I'm going to move that camera up close so you guys can see some of Sidney Crosby's best plays. I'm going to move it up close that you guys can see. I think that's good enough. Now, this was against the Edmonton Oilers during the 2018-19 season. So, see what he does here. So, as you can see, there's Sidney Crosby skating behind the net. Now, as you can see, that turn that he just did, he shrugs off. I believe that's Devin. I have no idea who that is right there. But he shrugs off him. There's Darnell Nurse in the corner right there. So after Sidney Crosby shrugs off him, let me go back so that you guys can see. So there's Sidney Crosby right there. And he makes that slight turn. This guy had his eyes locked on him until Sidney Crosby shrugged him off. Then this guy goes back to look around. And as you can see, there's Darnell Nurse right here. So this guy has to regroup. And Darnell Nurse, he's looking off in that direction. So he doesn't really know that Sidney Crosby is going to do something. This guy has to go back and regroup. So let me play it again. Now, as you can see, I just kind of played it. Now Sidney Crosby's right here. He has his eyes on Darnell Nurse, which he's looking off in the wrong direction. This guy has his eyes on Sidney Crosby. So he knows that Sidney Crosby probably might do something. Darnell Nurse has no idea because he's looking in the wrong direction. And Sidney Crosby sees that. This guy knows that Sidney Crosby knows that he's not going to get back in time, so this guy has to come up with a play. So, let me roll it. So there's Sidney Crosby, and as you can see, Darnell Nurse finally turns his head. He notices it, but it's too late because he was looking off in the wrong direction. This guy kind of already noticed it, but let me play it again. And so Sidney Crosby puts the puck between his legs. He cuts to the net, and boom, that's your OT winner right there. What a play from Sidney Crosby. Let me show it again. So there's that turn behind the net. Darnell Nurse finally realizes it, but it's too late for him to regroup. This guy already knows it. Cam Talbot already knows it because he's looking over there. This guy's looking over there, but it was all eyes on 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3 right there. So let me roll it.
Up here.
So see, there's the move by Sidney Crosby. As you can see, he puts the puck between his legs, and he puts the puck between his legs. Darnell Nurse tries to get back, but it's too late. The puck ends up in the back of the net. So that was just an outstanding play by Sidney Crosby. Let's show it again. Tight turn. And there's the deep, there's the move, there's the backhand, boom, puck is going top shelf in the net. Let me show you guys this next play.
The Avalanche killed off a fifth Penguins power.
I'm actually turning this down because this is kind of loud. Well, actually, you guys probably won't care. So, but anyway, this was from 2013 to not a goal, but this was an outstanding one. So, there's Sidney Crosby. There's Nathan MacKinnon. Both Stanley Cup winners, by the way, but that's not the whole point. I just want to show you guys the move. Sidney Crosby doesn't score a goal here, but he does an outstanding move I want to show you guys. So, Nathan McKinnon has his eyes locked on Sidney Crosby, and Sidney Crosby notices that. And so he makes this one move. Hang on, let me rewind it again, guys. So there's Sidney Crosby, there's Nathan McKinnon, both right there. Sidney Crosby gets the puck. So Sidney Crosby tries to make Nathan McKinnon trip. So he does like three deeks. So there's one right there, but you guys probably didn't see it. So he did three deeks, really. But,
on the left side of the screen, Nathan McKinnon. On the right side, Sidney Crosby. So Nathan says to Sidney, I'm going to show you a few things.
So see, there's where he kind of like, you guys probably didn't see, but there's where he likes pivots and makes that move. And Nathan McKinnon shrugs off and makes him trip. So there's the move right there. Outstanding move, I might add. Let me show you guys again. There's it right here. One, two, three. That's three beats right there. You guys probably only counted two. That was actually three beats. He makes Nathan McKinnon fall. That was a good move right there from Sid the Kid.
Puck to the net.
So this was in the playoffs. It was 2010. Not the whole point. But this was in the playoffs. So there's Sidney Crosby right there. Now the thing I like about Sidney Crosby is his edge work. I mean, this guy has incredible edge work behind the net, and basically, every time he plays hockey, he has an incredible edge work, which is one thing I like about him besides him doing all the backhands and stuff. Now, he does some edge work around the net. So, there he is right there. This guy has his eyes locked on him, and Eric Carlson's looking at him, but this guy has his eyes locked on him. And Sidney Crosby shrugs him off right there, and I think that's Jason Spezza right there. But Spezza has his eyes locked on him. So he follows him where he goes. He's behind the net again. And then he makes another move behind the net. And then another move. So Jason Spezza can't keep up with it. And then finally, Sidney Crosby passes it out to Chris Letang for the goal. So, incredible edge work by Sidney Crosby. That's what I want to show you guys. Now, there is this channel on YouTube called XX LaFlame, and he shows Sidney Crosby's highlights, so you guys can go to him. I'll put the link in the description, so you guys can go to his channel. But let's watch the edge work one more time. There's Spezza, there's Carlson. Focus on Spezza and Crosby. That's all I want you guys to focus on. Leave Carlson, I think that's Daniel Alfredsson right there. So leave Carlson and Alfredsson out the picture. Don't focus on them. Focus on Crosby and Spezza. Because that's what you should be focusing on. And it's because of the edge work that Sidney Crosby uses to shrug off Jason Spezza to get him off his back. So let's put it in slow-mo, which I probably should have done that for all my videos that I broke down. But see, put it in slow-mo. So there's Spezza, there's Crosby. I want you guys to focus on that. Focus on that. So Sidney Crosby makes his play. There's Spezza. He's still on Sidney Crosby. And then Sidney, watch that turn. Watch that turn. I'm gonna zoom up. Watch that turn. You see the turn of his skates right there. That's what I want you guys to look at. Look at the turn of his skates. He makes that incredible turn to shrug off Jason Spezza. So he kind of makes Jason Spezza trip by that incredible turn that he has. So I'm gonna zoom in closer so that you guys can see. His legs are slightly bent, but he makes that incredible turn to shrug off his defender, which is Jason Spezza. If you guys don't know, Jason Spezza retired, and I think he became a front office scout or whatever for the Toronto Maple Leafs. So he's now in the Toronto Maple Leafs front office. But let's get back to the breakdown. So there's that turn right there. So he kind of shrugs off Spezza a little bit. And watch the other turn right there. So stop it right there. So Spezza is going to go somewhere over here. And Sidney Crosby is going to go, okay, behind the net again. So he shrugs off Spezza like twice right there. So the whole point I'm trying to tell you guys is the tight turns, the edge work that Sidney Crosby has. Because I shouldn't say kid anymore because he's 30-something years old. But this was back then. He's 30-something years old, so not a kid, okay? But this was back then, guys. But anyway, watch the edge work. There's the second turn he did right there. So to all you young hockey players, if you want to work on your edge work, watch Sidney Crosby, because Sidney Crosby has the best edge work, probably one of the best NHL players I know who has the good edge work and the slight turns. So you young hockey players need to watch Sidney Crosby and watch his edge work, because I'm telling you, if you watch Sidney Crosby's edge work, you can be good at that too. And you can possibly make the NHL. But that's just like, you're really, really, really good. But I believe in all you young hockey players. I know you guys have potential to make it to the NHL. Let's get back to the play. So there's that turn again. And Sidney Crosby makes those tight turns. And as you can see, he's now falling. I don't know if Spezza makes him fall. I'm trying to see. I don't think his stick got him, but he's now falling. So he doesn't just fall and be on the ice and let this guy gets it. No, he instead passed that puck out to a wide open Chris Letang. Look, see guys? Sidney Crosby makes an incredible play. There's nobody near Letang. It's just Letang all alone. And he takes that clapper, boom, and the puck ends up in the back of the net. And that's what I also want to talk about, guys. You cannot leave guys open. Because if you leave guys open like that, they have a 50-50 chance to score, just like Chris Letang did. And watch this. 1-2. There's two of these guys. There's another person in front of this guy. So look at the screen in front of the net. Look at the screen. That's why. That's another reason why Chris Letang was able to score that. Because the screen in front of the net. Like there's a screen in basketball. There's a screen in hockey. So there's a screen in front of the net. These are two guys, you guys. There's one person behind this guy right here. So those two guys are setting the screen. And Chris Letang has all that wide open space to get the puck in the back of the net. Now let me play it. And boom. The puck goes past Elliott. And Chris Letang has a goal. Now let me show you guys. Let's see how long we into this. About 13 minutes. Past 13 minutes. Let me show you guys this. Another good play. Of course, you gotta wait for the ad.
Start the day slow roasting turkey for incredible flavor.
Wait for the ad, guys.
Then double seal every slice for freshness. The results, they speak for themselves. Hillshire Farm, made right on the farm.
All right. Now this was another good play from Sidney Crosby. This is another edge work. Now see, watch. I think this is Donato right there. Now don't focus on any of these other guys right here. Don't focus on them. Focus on him. Focus on him. Focus on Crosby. Focus on Donato. Focus on these two right there. Now Sidney Crosby, he's gonna go behind the net. He's gonna go behind the net. Watch the turn. And this is what I want to tell you guys, especially to all you young hockey players. Who want to be like Sidney Crosby. Watch the turn. Watch the turn right there. You see the turn? That's what I want to tell you guys about. Because what Sidney Crosby is capable of, he's capable of making those tight turns behind the net. And he does it to Ryan O'Donnell. That's why he's looking off in the other direction instead of Sidney Crosby. Now, what I'm about to show you is that once Sidney Crosby gets done making that tight turn, he sees his teammate, Dominic Simone. He passes out to him, and the Penguins have a 6-2 lead. Let's roll the clip. So Donato is gone. He's now gone. But he now realizes he has to regroup. He has to get back on track. But Sidney Crosby now knows it. And there's Donato trying to get him again. But Sidney Crosby passes the puck right here to his teammate Dominic Simone. And boom. The puck is in the back of the net. Alright. So that's why I want to show you guys the tight turns that Sidney Crosby has behind the net. And like I said, this is what he's capable of. Oh, I didn't know that was. This is what he's capable of. Capable of making those tight turns. So let's do it again. There's Donato. There's Crosby. There's the turn right there. There's the turn right there. You see, there's the turn. There's Donato. He's looking off in the other direction. Sidney Crosby's trying to making the tight turn, like I said. Let's roll the clip. So there's Donato, but he now realizes that he's not on Sidney Crosby anymore. So he tries to regroup, but it's too late. Because Sidney Crosby already passed it, and boom, Dominic Simone has a backdoor tap in. What a play by Sidney Crosby. Have you guys watch it one more time? There's the tight turn. There's the play from behind the net, and there's the wide open pass to Dominic Simone. Let's go on to the next play. Actually, I wanted to skip that. I'm gonna skip this one, guys. I'm gonna show you guys an even better play. So I'm gonna skip this one. Show you guys. Now, as you guys didn't know, this was in the 2016 Stanley Cup Final when the Penguins won the Stanley Cup against the San Jose Sharks. And P.S., I watched all six games. Really good series, by the way. Very happy for Pittsburgh winning the Stanley Cup. Sidney Crosby getting his second Stanley Cup that year. And he will go on 1 year later to win his third Stanley Cup, which was in 2017. Both of those years, 2016, 2017, were his playoff years, which I kind of told you guys at the start of this video. But let's focus on this play right here. So, roll the tape. There's Chris Letang. There's Sidney Crosby. Now, Sidney Crosby, he's capable of making plays from behind the net. And where's Sidney Crosby? He's behind the net. He's behind the net. And there's Chris Letang. The left side of this net is open. So Chris Letang has all of that space right there to put the puck in. Because as you can see, the goalie is looking the other way. And Chris Letang knows that pass is coming. So he doesn't have to question like, is he going to pass to me or not? Because he already knows the pass is coming. Let me roll you the clip. And boom. And this was the game-winning goal in the Stanley Cup Final, by the way. This was the game-winning goal. And an incredible play for Sidney Crosby. And you guys have to know, like, imagine yourself playing against Sidney Crosby. Sidney Crosby might be making some of those edge work plays right there, like he just did. And that was the whole point of me making this video, to show you guys the edge work that Sidney Crosby has. So, roll it again. So this stuff going right there, right there in the corner. They get the puck out. There's Sidney Crosby. There's Patrick Hornquist. Let's focus on Sidney Crosby. And Chris Letang also makes a nice play, too, because he also goes behind the net, and he tries to get a chance right there. And Sidney Crosby picks up this puck, and he passes it to a wide-open Chris Letang. And Joe Pavelski slides down to make the play, but it is no good. It is no good right there. I'll show you guys again. And wide open net for Chris Letang. Boom. All right. I'm going to stop it right there. So, that is what I wanted to show you guys. I just wanted to show you guys the edge work that Sidney Crosby has. And maybe you young hockey players can apply it to yourself. What I would recommend is, if you want to see more of Sidney Crosby's footage, go to XX LaFlame. He has all the Sidney Crosby moves that you can think of. So I recommend going to his channel and watching that footage of Sidney Crosby. I also recommend, I'm going to put a GoPro video of Sidney Crosby doing all his creative skills in the description. And some products that I recommend getting. I recommend getting the Hockey Shot Defender, because with that, you can pretty much do anything. It's an on-off ice material. You can use it on the ice, you can use it off the ice. It doesn't matter. So I recommend getting that from Hockey Shot. Or if you guys are creative, you can find some stuff at home to make a defender. Like I did a DIY of this. So I basically used a stick, just some random stick, and a basketball to make my own defender and taped it together. So that was a DIY for me. So if you guys are creative, you can do that. But what I really recommend for you young hockey players is I recommend getting the Hockey Shot Defender, and I recommend going to that XX LaFlame channel, which, like I said, I'm going to put that in the description, and the GoPro video. So I recommend doing three of those things. The Hockey Shot Defender costs a lot of money, so hopefully your hockey parents will be able to get that for you. I'll put the link for that in the description. So if you want to go out and buy the Hockey Shot Defender, the link will be in the description at the end of this video. And that's going to do it for this video, guys. Hope you enjoyed. Hope you learned something. If you like this video, hit it with a like and hit that big red subscribe button. That's going to do it for this video, guys. I'll see you guys next time.